This is Session 9, Trim Clips and Add Transitions. Trimming adjusts where two clips touch, which is called the edit point. There are almost a dozen ways to trim clips, and this video showcases several of them, including the precision editor, the razor blade and trim tools, and dragging the edge of a clip with the mouse. Final Cut has many ways to trim. In this movie, we'll just cover the basics of trimming clips in the primary storyline. Oh, and by the way, we'll also discover snapping. Every edit point, that's the point where two clips touch, has three sides. The out of the outgoing clip, this is the trailing edge, the in of the incoming clip, the leading edge, and both the in and the out, one on each clip. Trimming changes the position of any of these three, just the out, just the in, or both the in and the out. Also, the audio edit point can be adjusted separately from the video edit point. This is called creating a split edit. Trimming does not delete any media from your hard drive. It just removes it from that particular project's timeline. A few definitions before we start. Handles are extra video before the in or after the out, which is part of the clip but not displayed in the timeline. Handles are essential for trimming and transitions. A ripple trim is where one edge of a clip is adjusted. Ripple trims always change the duration of the clip and the project. A roll trim is where both edges that touch, both the in and the out, are adjusted, but in opposite directions. Roll trims change the duration of both touching clips, but not the project. Slip and slide trims are covered in Chapter 10. The Precision Editor is a fast visual trimming tool that allows you to see exactly what you are trimming, but it only works with clips in the primary storyline. To display the editor, simply double-click an edit point. The Precision Editor can make both ripple and roll trims. It trims video and audio synced to video, but doesn't trim audio by itself. The big advantage to using the Precision Editor is that you can easily see the changes you are making and the clip handles you have to work with during the trim. Once our trimming is done, we need to move on to transitions, and there's three types of transitions. There's cuts, dissolves, and wipes. Cuts are an instantaneous change between shots. Dissolves slowly superimpose one shot over another, and wipes are a transition between clips using weird on-screen wildness. The default video transition is a 1 second dissolve, and this duration can be changed in preferences. The default transition can be applied to any selected edit point, a clip, a range between clips, or a group of clips. So let me show you how to toggle snapping off or on for trimming, how to cut a clip with the razor blade, then remove a through edit. I'll show you how to select an edit point and then open the Precision Editor and trim two clips, and I'll explain the difference between a ripple and a roll trim. I'll show you how to trim using the selection and the trim tools, and then we'll wrap up by adding the default transition to a selected edit point. I spend a lot of my time doing trimming, and when I trim, I need to turn snapping on and off. But what's snapping? Notice as I drag the playhead across a clip, it seems to want to snap or lock to where those two clips touch. When you're editing, this is wonderful because it prevents mistakes, but when you're trimming, they get in the way. To turn snapping off, click this icon right here. Keyboard shortcut is the letter N for snapping. An old mnemonic taught to me by Steve Martin. When this is blue, snapping is on. When it's gray, snapping is off. You want snapping off for trimming. Well, let's take a look at some really simple trimming first. Let's go back up to our toolkit here and select the razor blade tool. Keyboard shortcut is the letter B. We can drag inside any clip. And let's say I want to cut the clip right there. Notice the orange line that indicates where the cut is going to occur. Click the mouse and boom, it's cut. Now, this is new. And for people that have never used Final Cut before, you're going to say, who cares? But for people that have been using Final Cut since the beginning of time, this is really neat. Go back to the toolkit, go to the zoom tool. I'm just going to zoom out to fill that region. See that dotted line right there? That indicates what's called a through edit. There's no change in video. There's no change in audio. There's no break in time code. It's just a cut in the middle of a clip. And up until now, we could not fix these, but now we can. Select both sides of the through edit. I just simply dragged a marquee to select both clips before and after the edit. Go up to the trim menu, say join clips, and that through edit is gone. The clip is back to being a single clip. Now, in point of fact, the world does not end if you've got a bunch of through edits in your project. Nobody can see, but it drives editors nuts because it spoils the visual look of our timeline. Now we can fix it. It's a small thing, but I was jumping up and down when I saw it. Let's take a look at a shot here. If I play this, we've got the fire going to him pulling some glass out of the furnace. Watch closely. Look at the shape of the glass. Okay, I'm going to stop it right there. It's more like a vase shape. Okay, but now look what happens when he pulls it out. It's not a vase shape, and it's not even the same color. The shot order is correct, but what we have to do is mask the fact that this was shot in one city and this was shot in a different city. The process is the same, but I got to hide the fact that I'm looking at two different pieces of glass here. Trimming solves that. Editing puts our shots in the right order. Trimming smooths the action. The easiest way to trim is to simply double-click on an edit point. Double-clicking on an edit point opens the precision editor. You can do the same thing with Control-E. The outgoing clip is on top. The incoming clip is on the bottom. Notice when I click on this clip, there's a yellow border here indicating that I've got handles. That darker gray area represents extra video after the out, but there's no handle down here. As I drag this, notice the beginning of the clip is red, meaning I'm at the very beginning of the clip. But I can change this up here by grabbing the out. I'm doing a ripple trim. I'm just adjusting one side of the edit. I'm going to find it where he just starts to pull it out. So the move just starts right there and stop. Then I'm going to go down to here and find the spot. There it is. We'll just take it right from the very beginning. Lock that edit in place by pushing enter. Now when I play this, the action flows much more smoothly. Well, let's watch this a little bit further. Do one more trim here. He picks it up and starts to trim the glass. Notice the color of the glass. Notice the shape of the glass. I cut to the next shot. Different shape, different color. Actually, different color. Hand and shirt. But I love the drama of this shot. So I want to get the glass out of the furnace, but I don't want to dwell on it, and I don't want people to notice what the color is. Double-click the edit point. This time I'm going to trim this way back. So he just starts to flip it up right about there. Trim this one in, grab the bottom and drag it, and find the spot just before his hand reaches in. The left-hand picture shows the out of the outgoing clip. That's the one that I'm adjusting right now. The right-hand picture shows the incoming clip, the one at the bottom. When I'm happy with my edit, press the return key. Now when I play this, he takes it out, flips it up, and before we can even see what's going on and pay attention to the color of the glass, we're into something different, and you say, wow, look at that, even though obviously it's not the same. But we're masking that fact by doing trimming. When we're in the precision editor, I can trim one side of a clip by going up here, the other side of a clip by going down here, or roll the clip, trim them both at the same time to figure out what is the best spot. Where should I precisely switch from the left-hand shot, the outgoing clip, to the incoming shot, the right-hand clip? When you're happy, press the Enter key. Now, the precision editor just works the primary storyline, and it doesn't do audio by itself. It does video and audio sync to video. But still, for the visual process of seeing what handles are and how you trim and what happens when you move, the precision editor can't be beat. We can still do trimming, though, with the arrow tool. If I grab the edge of a clip and drag it, I'm doing a ripple to the in. This is sometimes helpful for experienced editors who don't need to see the precision editor. Or if I go up to the trimming tool, keyboard shortcut is the letter T, and click and drag, I'm now doing a roll by dragging the tool back and forth. This is exactly the same thing I could do inside the precision editor without having to open the precision editor. This is also useful for trimming clips inside connected storylines where the precision editor does not work. I have one more thing I want to show you, which is down here. They're applying glazes to the very hot glass, and notice I've got a bad jump cut here as they go from glaze 1 to shaping the glass. But it's important for me to see how those glazes get rolled. I want to apply a dissolve, a transition, between one shot and the other. To do that, select the edit point, type Command T, and now we have a smooth dissolve, implying the time has lapsed. We've got a change in time or place, which is what a dissolve means, as we go from one shot to the next. We can delete a transition by highlighting it. Remember, select something, do something to it, click it, hit the delete key, the transition's gone. We apply the transition by selecting the edit point and typing Command T. There's more we can talk about with transitions. We can change their time. We can do a bunch of adjustments. We'll talk a lot more about that in Chapter 12. Trimming makes the difference between just stringing clips together and creating a watchable movie. Trimming's really that important. Chapter 10 covers this in much more detail. While most of our projects will principally use cuts, dissolves and wipes also have their place. We cover transitions in Chapter 12. Once you discover the power of trimming, you'll never watch television the same way again. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks